Would you like to be able to record depositing the income that you earn from customers? Well, in this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course, you will learn how to record deposits from the customers you serve. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Customers pay you by check, cash, or credit card swipe, or even direct deposit. But ultimately, the money winds up in the company bank account. They pay you for some service you provided to the customer. That's the reason this deposit represents earned income. Use the deposits window to record the customer name, amount of money, and income account that relates to that deposit. Individual items of service or product are not relevant when doing minimum bookkeeping in the very summarized way that we're learning about in this course. So, for example, let's imagine on January 1 of 2020, Alan paid Vonda $2,000 for video services. The funds were directly deposited into the bank account. So what will be the results after we record this very first deposit? Well, right now your trial balance is empty. But if you physically deposited $2,000 into your bank account, that means that the cash in Chase Bank will show up in the trial balance for the very first time in the amount of $2,000. And if the reason we earned that $2,000 is providing a video service, then video income will also show up in the trial balance in the amount of $2,000. Let's take a look at how to record it. We record all transactions from the top left in the new plus sign menu. When we click, we go to the column of Other and click Bank Deposit. Bank Deposit. Even though the money was received from a customer, since we are doing it in the minimum way, we will click Bank Deposit. And you simply put in the information one by one. Notice QuickBooks chose the correct bank type of account to deposit the money into, and we are going for January 1 of 2022. So we received the money from customer Alan Arby, and the reason we received the money is because we earned video income. And in each of these cases, we just click the pull down arrow to make the choice we need to make for bank account, name, and account in the general ledger that represents the money we earned. Then all we have to do, normally we would put a description, we would put if we got cash or check. We'll just put cash for now, and we'll imagine it was directly deposited to the bank account. Of course, there would normally be a transaction number, but the amount is $2,000. And at the moment, let's just pull this up a little higher so you can see we can choose Save and New or Save and Close. Click Save and Close. And now let's check the results. When we click Reports and we go to Custom and Trial Balance, lo and behold, cash in bank shows up for $2,000 exactly as what we predicted, and video income shows up for $2,000 exactly as what we expected. Now let's do the next one. Let's imagine on January 2nd of 2022, Alan paid Vonda $1,000 for editing services, And again, the funds were directly deposited into the bank account. What will be the results? Well, if this is what the trial balance looks like before that transaction, and we just put an additional $1,000 into the bank account, then cash in Chase Bank becomes $3,000. And because this is the first time that we have earned editing income will show up on the trial balance for the very first time as $1,000. We'll record it the same way. Click New, Bank Deposit, put the date the money went into the bank, click Under Received From, then click the arrow and choose Betty Boop. Click the pull down arrow for account and choose editing income. Now, in a real situation, we might have more details about these three pieces of data, but let's skip over to amount, push tab, and now we have an amount for $1,000. And now we can click save and close, and you see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Now, let's see what the results look like in the other reports. If we click Reports and stay in the Custom Reports section, you can click Transaction List by Customer, and you can see there was one deposit from Alan on January 1st, and one deposit from Betty on January 2nd. And you can see the dates and amounts separated by customer. If you click Reports and then you click Profit and Loss, you will see the two individual income accounts with whatever balance was showing originally back over in the trial balance. But the difference in the profit and loss is that it will total the income section to tell you the total income. And later it will tell you the total expenses, even though the individual numbers are listed back over in the trial balance. Now let's try two more and see what happens. Let's imagine on January 3rd, 2022, Candy gave us $1,500 for video services rendered, and it's always deposited into the bank. So what will be the results? Well, how much did she give? She gave $1,500 specifically for video. So if you have $1,500 more in your bank account, cash in bank will become $4,500. And if you have $1,500 more earned in video income becomes $3,500. Let's go ahead and record it. So we click New, Bank Deposit. The date is January 3rd. Received from Candy. The account in this case is video income because that's what we earned. And the amount we earned and actually deposited, push tab. That's all you have to do. Now when you click save and close, click reports, trial balance, and now you can see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Let's just do one more. Let's imagine on January 4th of 2022, Alan gave us $2,500 for editing services that we rendered, and again, it's always deposited into the bank. So if we got $2,500 more specifically for editing, what will the results become in the trial balance? Well, cash in bank increases by $2,500 and becomes $7,000, and editing income increases by $2,500 and becomes $3,500. We click New, Bank Deposit, January 4th, received from Alan Arby. The account was editing income, and the amount. Now when we click save and close, the final numbers in our trial balance are exactly as what we expected them to be before the transaction. Now let's check the other reports, and you can see reports, and let's check the transaction list by customer. Now there are two transactions with Alan, so it gives us the total of the transactions. This total is an arbitrary number that is not particularly helpful because this report is simply a list of the transactions by customer. However, if you click reports and go to the profit and loss, you can now see that we've earned a total of $7,000 in income for each of the two $3,500 money amounts that are the results of the services that we rendered to the customer. Now, here's the big question. What if you made a mistake? If you made a mistake, it's very simple to fix. Just open the transaction from the detailed report, change what you want to change, and all reports and the numbers in those reports will change immediately. So the quickest way is to go to the detailed report. So transaction list by customer and vendor are two detailed reports that list each transaction. We can open up one of those and just double click on the one we want to change. And as soon as we save that change, all reports results will change with it. So let's do this. Let's make a really big change and see what happens. Okay, for example, reports, and we click transaction list by customer. Now let's imagine for Betty, instead of 1,000, we put 1,000,000. You can always open any transaction that you previously saved by looking at the report that lists the transaction individually, double click anywhere on the line right on that transaction, and the same window that you used to record that transaction will reopen. And you can make any change you want. You can change the customer, you can change the account. Let's change the money account to 1,000,000 or 10. 10 million, a huge, giant, absurd number going into editing income and going into the bank account. Look what happens when we click save and close. The results change immediately. Not only on this report, click reports, trial balance, the numbers immediately change on any report. You can also reopen and fix mistakes and change previously saved transactions from summary reports, like the trial balance or the profit and loss. They simply require an extra click. For example, this is a summary report, and this number in Cash and Chase Bank is the sum total of all of the transactions that were recorded in that account. But in any summary, you can double-click the summary number, and you will immediately get another report that shows the detail of every transaction that adds up to that summary number. You may have to scroll to the right or to the left to see the entire line of the transaction, but that's what you're looking at here. Now, if we scroll to the right, we can see that the offending transaction is this one. So as soon as we see the mistake in the list of transactions, we can double-click and we can change the number right back to what it was. Now that we made our change, we can click save and close, and immediately when we click reports, trial balance, the numbers go back to exactly what they were, and the result of the change happens immediately on all reports. so you are never lost in QuickBooks Online. You can always open the relevant report, change the transaction, and then as soon as you save it, all numbers will fix themselves immediately.